CROSBY'S Concussions, a brief timeline. On January 1st, 2011, it was the New Year's Day and the 4th NHL Winter Classic. It was a showdown of the two most anticipated rivals in the NHL, the Penguins and the Capitals, Sid vs. Ovi. However, it was anything but. It was a day that started it all. As the second period was about to close, CROSBY took a heavy and direct impact to his head by Washington forward Dave Steckel. The impact was a blindside shoulder as CROSBY was watching the play. No penalty would be given out and CROSBY eventually finished the game. Although everything seemed fine, a game against Tampa Bay Lightning would say otherwise. 4 days after CROSBY was hit by Dave Steckel, he was hit by Tampa Bay defenseman Victor Hedman on a board play. CROSBY would eventually go to finish this game as well, but it was later announced that he would be out for a week due to an upper body injury. And this would be the end of CROSBY's entire 2010-2011 season. Finally, after missing 61 regular games and 7 playoff games, Sid returned on November 21st, 2011, 10 months after reporting his first mild concussion. However, on December 5th, 2011, after only playing 8 games since his return, CROSBY takes a body from David Krejci. This ultimately resulted in a 3-month sideline for CROSBY, another recovery process knowing he can't help his team push for a playoff berth. Although the hit looks like a typical hockey check, I think this is a clear example of how fragile people can get after being diagnosed with a concussion even a year prior. CROSBY eventually returned on March 15th, 2012 after missing 40 games. On October 10th, 2016, CROSBY missed the first 6 games of the 2016-2017 season after being diagnosed with a concussion due to an incident at practice. Although this seems minor, it tells me that even after his first reported concussion in 2011, CROSBY is still delicate and his recovery isn't at 100%, as all concussions typically go. And finally, on May 1st, 2017, round 2 of the playoffs against Washington, CROSBY collides with defenseman Matt Niskanen's stick. While his head is the primary contact of collision, he is currently ruled out for next game as his return date is unknown. CROSBY's history indicates he is still vulnerable and repeated impacts could have serious implications, more serious than the next. Furthermore, it doesn't matter for me if it was intentional, planned, or an accident. Unless there is a clear evidence of intent, all we can do as fans is just speculate. I fear that CROSBY's constant and repeated contacts to the head will shorten his career. And as a hockey fan, I just hope CROSBY comes back after he is fully declared for contact again, because he truly is the best hockey player in the world today.